It's time to build the ultimate tech YouTuber office in this space that's like 3 times the size of what we currently work in. In this series, powered by eBuyer, I'm gonna be filling this office with a load of cool YouTube tech and covering it every step of the way. Back in 2020, eBuyer actually invited us up to take a look at their insane headquarters. And we're gonna be covering some of the awesome tech they sell later on in this series. This video actually starts here though, in our current office. I moved in on my own back in March, and it's safe to say we've outgrown the space just a tiny little bit. Since then, we've grown to 3, nearly 4 people now, and cover loads, loads more products. So I think the first thing to do really is to gut this space and get everything moved over to the new office. Dan, on the camera, picked the easiest job today, and no one can argue that. We've made quite a lot of progress this morning. The time is about 11:15. Our desks are in. These, of course, are IKEA specials, but they look quite nice. We've got some corner desks, so that's my desk over on the left-hand side. We've then got editor Dan over here. We've got editor Jake here, and then we've got another desk going here for an undisclosed individual that you guys don't quite know about just yet. We're also gonna pop some shelves on this wall here for like product samples and stuff. That's probably the next step. But really, I mean, this space feels absolutely huge. Like I can just, the fact I can keep walking and walking and walking and walking, this is ridiculous. Oh, before that though, we've got the small challenge of actually moving Jake's desk into the new office. And that means actually taking apart his entire setup, most of which is gonna get changed because he's actually getting an upgrade. He's getting like 3 triple monitor, 32-inch setup. And we also need his desk for somebody else. So that means all of his stuff does indeed need to go. Should probably keep these safe. It's only like the files for the next like 10 important, 10 GeekaWhat videos. Big shout out to MSI, by the way. They sent us this 4K curved monitor, which I'll link at eBuy in the description below. And this, we've been editing on it now for kind of about 7 months, and it is absolutely amazing. The colors are super accurate, and it's also decent if you want to do a bit of 4K gaming. So definitely something to consider, but more on monitors a little bit later. Now, you guys are probably also noticing the challenge we're going to have with these shelves, and also the number of RTX cards we need to move to the other office. I know some people are going to be like, James, there's no RTX 3000 series stock. Don't worry, it is coming back in stock. Once again, I'll put those links in the description down below. And the reason we have so many is because brands kind of lend them out for videos. Some of these do need to go back, so we need to look after them and use videos on them and then send them back. But hopefully I can keep one over Christmas for Cyberpunk. Probably a 3080 for Cyberpunk. Front might support itself now that they come together. Here you go, look at this. It's stainless. Sorry to all our new neighbours, this is not the impression we're trying to give. Oh, I'm gonna have to come back. Jake, can you just stand there with this stuff? Come back with this stuff.
This just looks like I've made the mess.
So the office is now finally starting to come together. We're just gonna bring the excess lights in. And editor Jake is behind me with the TV. So we've got like a 40-inch 4K Samsung panel, and that makes sure we get everything nice and sharp in focus. Thermal tip cases are cool and they're unique, but they're absolutely huge. And it's making my shelf physically, this is like a 150 kilo shelf, it's physically bending. Like, that is ridiculous. on a level, right? These are absolutely genius. Oh, shit. So, update time, we're kind of heading towards the end of day one of the move. You can see most of the storage is kind of in. We've still got like the odd case box like lying about that needs solving. And we've still got this kind of stuff that does need to go on those shelves. But, as you would have seen, we've got the drawers in now. So this is all the kind of studio equipment we need. This is not the PC building gear. That's in the drawers in the partition area. All of the desks are in. If we head in here, the 45-inch TV on wheels is now also in as well. We've got one of our lights in. I think it makes sense to go and grab some of the production gear next, get that in, and make kind of the studio sort of ready to be tweaked with tomorrow, really. And I'm really tired and sweaty. The next step today, then, is actually the bit I've kind of been putting off all day, and it's now... It's about 20 past three, we've got about an hour left really of the day, and that's actually repurposing my electric sit-stand desk as a recording desk. To do that, we need a new tabletop going on, which means we've got to take the current tabletop off, and the whole thing needs to take completely apart because it will not fit through the door in the new office without it.
How have you never lost footage?
Yeah, I know, right? There we go. So, this is the original white IKEA filming desk that we've used for probably about a year now, and we're gonna pop on this electric frame. Now, in theory, this should all like just work sort of out the box, really. I think I'm probably gonna have like the up and down controller this side so that like the person that's filming or being filmed, sorry, can control it. That's the word I'm looking for. Right, now, we haven't actually had screw holes tapped, so I'm kind of hoping that we can kind of just screw straight in to the MDF. I think that's working. Oh my God, that's, wait, is that it? I think it's working, chaps. Everyone keeps taking the mick out of me, right, because I bought an electric screwdriver, and this is why. Look at this! Who needs a screwdriver when you've got this thing? Once you're in, you can just whack this bad boy in. Was it 30 quid? Yes, it was. So this is okay. This is all okay. There is, if this dies after this move, then so be it.